Today we have a third lecture on medical informatics, and I will try to provide introduction into question related to medical images, analysis and processing. Topic very broad, very large, and actually images, it's major information source, one of the maybe largest information source in modern diagnostic and the other medical tasks, but within single lecture it's actually almost impossible to present some detailed information on this topic. Moreover, such as I am IT professional, technology professional, not physician, so I will make emphasis on information technology question. Medical aspects of usage of images in diagnostic process, for sure you will consider day to day during your education process within right now and all next year as well until the end of your education. So, again, I will concentrate on question related to information technology usage and will try to also provide just like some essential characteristics of digital medical images as well as some possible approach for analysis and processing. I'm sorry, I kindly ask you to be quiet and pay attention for this topic, if it's possible. So here is a question related to possible mutual respect. But until now, I did not see it, lost the things. Maybe only several students like this. Okay. Three major questions will be considered. Place of imaging within medical science, like general points, then question, technical question related to physician analysis and processing, actually major part in lecture, and PACS, usage of PACS and DICOM as special information system solution dedicated to DL with medical images. So, okay, let's move into first question. Well, for the first I want to sign, that's when we talk about medical imaging, we must every time ensure that we are discuss about multidisciplinary field where multiple scientific or practical area has been intersect and they are all together with general goal, aim. Also, a little bit classify approach to classification of medical images according to several technical principles and kind of information which is available within medical images. I will try to present. So let's start on this. So first of all, as I told, imaging it's like one of the most important information sources in modern medical science. So essential aspects of medical science for visualization, anatomical structure, as well as for understanding function required. It's provide for us better understanding of anatomy of human's body, understanding of physiology, process, principles of how human organs work, behavior and relationship between different activities, and so on. So it's critically important to have ability to retrieve and manage with medical images in modern time. So actually, with development, like modern time of medical imaging development age, being started with inventing of different imaging instruments, so we can point it at the beginning from like printing technologies which allow mass production of images. Next stage, it's like the late Middle Age. Next stage, next breakthrough, it's of course development of photography which allow realistic pictures of real world. And at the end of 19th century, so again I'm talking photography invented during 19th century, and at the end of 19th century it's showing inventing of X-ray recorded effects, so ability to usage X-rays for visualization and for recording of medical image. So from this technical revolution, it's inspired findings, scientific search, engineering solution for further image management and processing. And of course, next step, next turn will be its invention of digital computers at the after Second World War, when we have ability to manage data in digital format and immediately become proposal to convert analog image into digital format and apply computational power to processing digital image. And then, so here is we have like sequence of different invention which is required to bring us in position where we are already here right now with ability to perform advanced image processing. And if you will check background of each of these steps, so we will have intersection of multiple scientific area, physics, chemistry, later of course mathematics every time, and later informatics and computer science. And now it will be about the 20th century. So here is what I signed, why we are talking about multidisciplinary field as medical informatics, medical imaging area. So at the time we have ability to not only store and manage a digital image, but also we have ability to uplift computer system computational algorithms to perform analysis, measures, processing, and even simulation of object based on data retrieved and reconstructed from digital image. So, and as a result, we have ability even up to automatic computer application of computer-aided diagnostics principles and computer-guided treatment method. So, of course, major advantage and major results of application modern digital image could be found within diagnostic radiology as medical specialty. So, major contribution available here. And it's give evolved, and as a result, the significant contribution number of different disciplines from basic science, engineering, medicine involved in the construction of medical image. So, for example, I will just try to turn around the soup which I signed every time when we want to retrieve kind of image of our body or part of body or organ. It should be based with modern time on some kind of current understanding of this object or process, location, behavior, accessibility also. And to get the image we need, every time I'm talking about instrumental imaging system, we need some kind of physical principles being used. No matter what you use it, like natural light illumination and conventional optical camera or X-ray system, CT scan machines, ultrasound system. So all this requires first of all understanding of physics of process and understanding of which kind of physical work parameters affected within this and involved with this organ or process life cycle. As a result, based on physics, we have ability, aptly engineering skill to create image acquisition system, like some kind of practical or camera, or maybe you can talking about some X-ray machine, CT scan system, ultrasound, practical ultrasound system, and so on. So this instrument allow for us actually register changes in a physical process, for example, register and to register that signals which comes from particular physical effects and convert it into kind of data, and even improve this data, turn it into usable information, if you remember my first lecture. So at the output of acquisition system, we should have kind of information which could be represented typically in digital, in modern time, as digital data sequence. So it could be file of particular format, if you talk about medical system, or okay, even it could be printed copy. But for the first major aim, it's get digital sequence. It's to get digital data, because in this case, if we have digital container with visual, which represent visual data, we have ability to apply next step. We have ability to apply computer processing methods with like printed copy. So actually no other way, that's manual assessment by human physician. So when we have digital sequence, we can apply computer processing methods, algorithm, we can apply analysis algorithms, even we can try kind of simulation. And with all this, if you talk about scientific process, not only diagnostics, actually it's bring us for understanding about some particular problem which related to particular patient or even group of it or general problem. And as a result, we can plan our application of intervention, create, make diagnosis, create treatment plan, and apply it, made assessment of result. So, which could even give for us better understanding of what physiology current understanding of this particular case which happened with this particular patient. And we'll probably turn around if we want to just make assessment of results of our treatment. Or based on processing of multiply observation, we can create better diagnostic instruments to get more effective, more detailed data with best significant information, with better significant information. And again, repeat and repeat this cycle one more time. So when, if we will turn slightly into classification of medical images, so lots of approach available for this task. Even we can start by medical specialities or by techniques which have been used. So, for example, I will present not all possible classification, but only few of that classification, even sometimes very simple, depending to different criteria that is interesting for me. For example, when we're talking about multidimensional modalities, so here is we could present the following list of classes of medical images, depending to aim, depending to principles of usage, and depending to techniques being used. Another approach for classification by energy source, like external, internal, or combined, If we will use the same modalities and will try to fit it in this classification, so you can see how it will be rearranged depending to kind of energy being used. So only, for example, one instance available for internal energy usage. And for current slide, we have a representation at least three different classification. So we have, we can classify medical image. So here is, we have more relative to physical background, physical effects background, physical principles of obtaining. We can classify wavelengths required, wavelengths of signal, frequency of signal, or energy required should be recorded or required to obtain some kind of significant information about this. And here is place that actually only three particular medical imaging diagnostic methods like MRI, X-ray, and gamma ray imaging. But what is final results of like, no, not final, what is actually first requirements of medical imaging? After we have ability to register physical effect, our question is get some measure of changes within, for example, particular frequency wavelength of energy and convert it into something visible for humans, for us. So as a result, we need to set data into wavelength, frequency, and energy which fit into visible light. So please check again, remember physics. How narrow is our ability to observe the universe? How thin and narrow we have our capabilities compared to full spectrum of signals which could be obtained? So every time if we need to process, if we want to see results of examination, we need to perform turn of wavelength, frequency, and energy into that diapason which is fit visible light. So as a result, if you talk about that we see results of X-ray imaging of FMRI, I'm sorry, we observe not reality, we observe a reconstruction adjusted to our abilities to accept kind of visual information. Because reality here in that particular areas, every time we doesn't observe reality with fMRI X-ray, we observe some arrangement and modified data adopted to us, to our capabilities. And here is critical, and it's even with advanced visualization, it's even more complicated, difficult, and more intense. So, but it's why I'm slightly move forward. Okay, still back to classification. So kind of information could retrieve like anatomical or functional metabolic. And here is several techniques listed which could provide this information. Sometimes we can retrieve both kinds of information with particular techniques, sometimes only one kind. For example, ultrasound available within both groups or modification of MRI also. For sure, at least it's not full, it's just brief overview and just examples of what we can do with this. So, okay, classification could be extended much more, even whole lecture will be not enough to when we talk about classification of medical imaging. Now move into question closely to acquisition, analysis, and processing process itself. So first of all, when we talk about medical image, we need to get some instruments, device which allow for us to retrieve of this image. And it should be conventional image processing or image acquisition system, which will image analysis system, which will consist of three major parts every time. So it will be acquisition component which is responsible for convert biomedical signal radiation carrying information interest into digital data, into digital data sequence. So they have got a digital image, but it's actually even not fully correct. We are talking about digital data sequence, which could be represented and formed into image. No matter what we are talking about, even if you will consider your smartphone camera, so sensor, lens and sensor system, this will be image acquisition component. It should be responsible to like convert visible light which fall into the system and fall through the system onto the surface of sensor into from visible light energy and frequency into electrical signals and then digitizing, because in our modern diagnostic device, results of image acquisition, it's digital signal, not enough. Next point, DCU unit or digital computer system unit, which is responsible to keep data, to keep medical, to keep digital sequence, this time typically in form of particular image data, digital image data format or file format, and also perform like conventional operation about management, like load, save, and of course prepare like rendering to visualization. So if you talk about, it will be used again smartphone as example, it will be for sure CPU smartphone and internal storage of smartphone and system bus for it, of it, which will represent DCU. And of course screen, which will be being used for visualization purpose. So any device actually fall into this simple structure. Even if we will talk about like advanced computer tomography, okay, in this case, acquisition system will be very complicated. So is that ring to where a patient passes through it to retrieve images. And DCU unit that time will be like typically separate computer system, sometimes represented not by single but multiply computers. And even DCU unit could be not only single screen, but system of screens or even modern true three-dimensional display like holographic or mechanical three-dimensional displays or so. But every time we will have this structure of three components. Every time when we talk about medical, not only medical, but we are concentrating it, medical image processing analysis system or acquisition system. So this time we will multiply time, use the term digital image, maybe time to summarize some backgrounds, your background, because you should have it, you must have this background, and clearly understand what is, how we can consider what is image itself and how we can consider it. So when we will talk about multidimensional image starting from two-dimensional, we can consider it as two-dimensional signal. So every, if you talk about flat image, even like this one shown in the screen, we are talking about two-dimensional signal, which is represented by x and y coordinates, vector coordinates. And if you talk about analog representation, like continuous real world, okay, things, what light from that lamp projected to this wall or floor, no matter where, but we are talking about flat signal, so you talk about projection. Is it from top to bottom, from left to right or so? So here is, we talk about continuous signal, when each point at particular xy coordinates will be represented by function of the coordinates. So here is the pixel value at this xy coordinates, we are talking about elementary part of the image, which you call it pixel, and characteristics of this pixel, it will be value of function. So characteristics of pixel could how we can characteristics of picture in general. So we will start for sure from like picture size or resolution. How many points do we have within both axes? So quite small resolution, but for example, no, maybe again I made one step forward. If you will compare resolution of computer modern computer tomography systems, so like 4 megapixel, it's very high resolution, it's very advanced tomography. Let's check compare this resolution with smartphone camera, which could be 12, 20, even I saw marketing advertise about 30 megapixel camera. For tomogram, 4 megapixel, 2048 by 2048 points within both direction. It's very large, it's very advanced and extremely perfect image. Typically, medical diagnostic device have much lowest resolution than optical cameras. So also we can talk about characteristics of particular pixel. It could be like in case if you talk about black and white image, it will be two value. For grayscale, it could be intensiveness of gray components. So as a result, we have like 1 byte per pixel value up to from 0 up to 256 value of intensiveness. If we talk about full color image, so they are depending to form of representation. Full color image, it will be information about color components of each image. For example, if you talk about RGB-SM, if you use RGB-SM, so this will be intensiveness of each one channel within a single picture. So this time, function for single function result for single pixel value will contain not only one value, but array, which will consist of several values. For example, per channel intensiveness, and may some very often brightness, contrast, or something other. So in this case, if we try to consider three-dimensional image, okay, no problem. This time, pixel, like element on flat picture, will be replaced with voxel or volumetric pixel, and we will talk about characteristics of this volumetric element. So, like in, if you will consider picture like this room, so at end of this pen will be particular volumetric element characteristics. If you will talk, want to talk about dynamical image, again, in this case for flat images, we will add third coordinate, third axis temporal coordinates, and it will be sequence of flat images which exchange with particular rate. And we will have like at least 25 frame per second, 25 pictures per second give for us minimum basic quality video video stream. If you want to best quality, 50 frames or more required or so. If we will talk about dynamical three-dimensional, we will talk about four-dimensional signal this time. Three coordinates like x, y, z and force temporal. So here is every time we will have function which will represent characteristic of image in particular point at flat image or in particular volume for volumetric image. And next important point, we must every time understand that digital image will be every time worse than original continuous signal. So if you will try to make projection of like reflector or attenuated energy from particular element through imaging system onto imaging plan. For example, even again, if we use a smartphone, a camera as example, so when you take photo, natural light illuminates your object, it reflects light, and it will be directed through imaging system, through lens, onto surface of sensor. At surface, we will have like reflection, continuous signal, reflection of real object. But at output, at the end, and at the out, at the side of sensor, when it have converted into digital representation, we have things which shown at right side, because sensor not continues itself. Sensor is discrete. Sensor consists of multiply elements, or each one is responsible for pixel. So for sure, so more sensor we have, so better our image will be. But we have limit, every time we have limitation. We can't create sensor like small that even without size. They will have some final size, some final dimension. It could be smaller, very, very, very small, but it should be that like several microns required to get something useful. And as a result, we will have image like this, we will have some degraded information at left side. What we have at input, at surface of sensor, at right side, what we have at output, what how sensor array convert input into output signal. So here is why resolution of sensor is critical. Resolution of sensor, number of sensitive elements, number of pixels. So more elements we have, better image, more closely to origin we will have. And actually, if you will turn into mathematic, above it's signals at sensor surface, but it fall in sensor, below results of digitizing matrix of value. Above we have continuous signal, so like reflected light every time fall into camera, every time we have continuous signal. But you take a shot, you take photo, and you get only, you convert continuous, you get only one frame from continuous signal and get recorded. So here is we got matrix with some discrete value for each one pixel. What I want to sign at this point, every time when we talk about digital image, actually we talk about matrix which represent characteristics of each one picture element or each one pixel. So every time when we will talk about image analysis and processing, we will deal with what kind of branch of mathematics? Matrix algebra. Matrix algebra. If you want to process digitized image, the only matrix algebra, this will be our first background. These things. No matter, even you will use a specific software with graphical user interface, different buttons, sliders, adjustment tool, and so on. Okay, you do. You can. But behind the scene, every time will work matrix algorithms. And you must be aware about this. And actually, how it's looked like practically. Like user typically see things like this one at the left top corner. Like we have microscopic image, typically, maybe DNA chain or so. If you will use a magnifying tool to enlarge this image, you will have, we will see things like shown at left side at the bottom. Set of square pictures, which one represents one of the origin. And if you will look in original data sequence, it will be things which is available at right side at the bottom. So what is behind each one digital image? In this case, we talk about grayscale. So we have like value from 1 to 200, 265. If we will talk about color image, okay, each one cell which will contain not one value, each one cell which contain several value, at least RGB characteristics, at least three value for RGB channels. Or it could be three matrix, one per channel, and we can add the fourth matrix, some brightness, fifth matrix contrast, or we can even add the more matrix for more characteristics of each one pixel. It's possible. And process, how sampling works. It's right top corner, how it's were obtained. Here is again, I sign every time video with matrix when we talk about analysis and processing. So if we want to make kind of analysis, we need to check, is it possible with matrix algebra? If matrix algebra talk, it's possible, okay, we will get result definitely. If matrix algebra talk impossible, I'm sorry, it will not work. Okay, now I will turn into second part of second question about transmission image and related techniques which allow to construct images. So this is like a large section of presentation, and several part of it I will be passed through relatively quickly. So that part which is closely related to biophysics or so, I will try to slightly skip and will concentrate only on several points which is more related to information technology itself and to specific algorithm solutions or so. So first of all, most advanced image we can ability to receive with true transmission approach to medical image, which are presented by principles when radiation attenuate when passed through human body. So in this way we can get information from of internal structures of organs, tissues, etc. inside without inside of body without cross-section. So for sure we can start from X-ray radiography, then next achievements will be tomography, but also we have ability to receive kind of image with infrared and even optical techniques. Transillumination, for example, approach can give for us like internal skin structures, microwave and other registration. So for sure at the end of 19th century, everything has been started at the end of 19th century with invention of Conrad and Röntgen, or not only his, because actually at least several the physics got similar results, he just more quickly with patent registration. So anyway, it's have ability, we got ability to visualize and registration of results of what's happened when X-ray images pass through a human body. So in modern radiology X-ray system, for sure films being replaced with digital sensor like similar used in smartphone camera, and create not only a image projection on film, but as output we have digital image, digital sequence. So, but what parts, what steps were necessary to get from like basic X-ray visiography, so displaying of X-ray on screen, because for the at the beginning it's even impossible to get film copy. At the beginning it will be possible only observer images on basic screen into computer tomography. So for this actually like it's very necessary about more than 70 years to get from conventional X-ray visualization into computer tomography, which provide at the beginning two-dimensional images. Later it's evolved into three-dimensional visualization In this time, we can talk about dynamical three-dimensional reconstruction, creating dynamical three-dimensional model with by using computer tomography techniques, and it even could be applied for different image acquisition techniques. So, if you talk about particular CT tomography, useful for represented hard structures like bones, and less useful for soft tissue. But actually, same principles could be applied, for example, with an MRI imaging, which is in this case much better to visualize soft tissue and not so good for hard, and so on. And even I will put more. So first of all, what is computer tomography itself, like projection process? So it's representation of photo slice and implies formatting of 2D three-dimensional cross-section image, free of warning from structures not in the planes of interest or tomograph. Actually, definition. Sounds may be significantly complicated and fairly useful. But if you will like consider this projector as X-ray source and screen as sensor or field, no matter. So direct, when I put any object inside between screen and projector, I get shadow. It will be like conventional X-ray. Shadow will be conventional X-ray. But if I will be able to look not on shadow, but using information in shadow, if I will be able to turn, like to look in any perpendicular projection, from like side or top or bottom, so here is will be tomogram. In other case, here is this one. Top part represent conventional X-ray. Bottom part, we use the same physical principles, same physics. I say same physics we use. Even almost the same devices, at least source should be the same, X-ray source should be the same. We need just perform adjustment of sensor array, or we cannot use the film directly, because even first generation of CT scan output results on film, but they have used a digital sensor. Here is problem, because we can't use a film directly in computer tomography. Because major part is reconstruction of image by computer system, and we have ability, we review same like organ, but we get information not in focal plane, we get information in another plane, like horizontal or vertical, no matter which one, depending to how we will turn patient in or subject in our system. So here is this one, computer responsible for reconstruction, advanced information from that shadow data which registered by detectors. As a result, you must be aware, every time when we talk about computer tomography imaging, we talk about not that it represents reality, we talk about synthetic computer visualization based on knowledge, based on mathematics, based on experience. Here is key points here. Or even better, maybe representation. So we have again salt, but this time with collimator, we have detectors. So we can like register thin shadow within detectors, but our goal yet not what this thin cut. Our goal is get information inside, like looking from vertical direction into this. How it's possible? Not just by computer itself. Here is problem not in computer. Here is achievement in mathematic action. I sign in mathematics. So before this, before I will turn into mathematics, pair of notice. Same information technology solution. Same informatic, mathematic, and information, mathematic achievement, and informatic technologies implementation of that achievements this way could be used not only for conventional CT scan, like nuclear medicine tomography, SPECT and PET tomographs, magnetic resonance imaging, MRI, functional MRI. So we are talking about completely different acquisition system. We are talking about completely different scanning system acquisition components of imaging device. But if we will turn into image processing principles, we will meet the same background, the same mathematical achievement, and very, very similar software solution used to reconstruct medical image. So, from physical, from engineering viewpoint, that tomograph, CT, MRI, nuclear tomograph, completely different. From informatic viewpoint, there is no significant difference between all them, because same algorithms and similar software solution being used. So here is will be okay steps how we get from X-ray into computer tomography. First of all, physical achievement in physics and basic engineering. So definition about that we have ability to use X-ray as kind of information source, and engineering achievement like creating first X-ray system, like end of 19th century. Next point, absolutely not related to previous, mathematical results, so-called Radon transformation. Several next slides I will try to present like essential mathematical solution for it, but it's like very complicated things. Okay, like even in within first World War time, it was presented this achievement on scientific conference. It's actually at that point, at that time, it's like abstract mind game about possibility to establish relationship between rectangular coordinate system and polar coordinate system, and get formula which allow to join position of point within these two coordinate system. No more. It's like absolutely unuseful at that time. But with further mathematical analysis and investigation, we are determined also backward radon transformation, which allow to get back from polar into back into rectangular coordinates. Also was determined that so-called projection theorem, which explain our full relationship between this. Next, we identified similarity between radon and Fourier transformation, which allow significantly simplify and reduce complexity of calculation. And with inventing of digital computers, with inventing of first scanner, which allow digitize images and turn them into digital sequence, a nice idea to apply that mathematical principles to digitize an image to get that things, not see what we will have in shadow, but to get into shadow from another direction and gather information from here. And it's how computer tomography born. So physics, mathematics, then informatics, then engineering, and we got it. Actually, what is in fact radon transformation? Establish relationship between rectangular and polar coordinates, and how we can determine signals G from S theta over interval. No, it's like not easy to be calculated. Mr. Don't do it without computer, because there is no computers in 1970. So scientists can do if it's real scientist, if he's a real scientist. And here is how we can turn it into matrix representation for relationship to polar coordinates. By default, Radon transformation result almost useless, because if you took origin, so at right side origin, at left side we have results of Radon transformation. If you try to visualize it, it's fairly useful for our eyes and for understanding too. But it's contained information. Each pixel here contains information. And we can use this information to provide for backward reconstruction. So we need first of all invert Radon transformation, and for sure so more projection we will have, so better results will be. And here is actually approach how we can revert back Radon transformation. Even honestly for me, this mathematical solution too advanced, honestly too advanced, because I am no such good into mathematics. I will not ask you about understanding this. I just want to show you level of complexity when we talk about reconstruction of computer tomography imaging. So here is solution like Paris number for this. And here is a relationship between Radon, reverted back Radon transformation and Fourier transformation. So we have forward and backward Radon transformation. And as you can see, similarity between backward Radon and Fourier transformation here shown at the right side. So we can replace backward Radon with two-dimensional Fourier transformation for rectangular x and y coordinates. And you will get almost the same result, So it's allow for us to significantly reduce complexity of that particular transformation and get the following solution. Here, so for polar coordinates. And actually, what do we will have? Like this diagram at left bottom corner represent for us input data information, continuous Radon, continuous data about Radon transformation, like input and output, we will have reconstructed two-dimensional coordinates of point. So, like, if you want after that get three-dimensional image, you will need to perform rotation of focal plane and multiply time, and we will get such information. Of course, every time we are talking about computerized rotation, so rotation of transformation of matrix data in a proprietary way. So final solution shown here. Of course, there are signs that it's not exactly precise solution. We are talking about as much possible closely solution to reality. And here is what we can have. Origin of data, recorded sinogram or actually data retrieved within forward Radon transformation, and we will perform backward transformation with help of simplified Fourier transformation. We will get Z6 at right side. In dynamic, we see how quality better depending to number of projection. More projection, more better image we will have at right side. Okay. And here is how we can further, it's only for single one. So previous slide, represent case if you talk about one slice. If we will use a continuous scanning of patient, we will get the so-called stacked image. Multiply such scan like at right side, but it will be separate image. If you want to reconstruct three-dimensional model, we will need to use all that image from right side and apply Fourier transformation again, pure projection, and we will get into three-dimensional object. We start from origin, and through all these attempts, we will get into three-dimensional simulation of it. I sign. As a result, when we talk about construction three-dimensional object, three-dimensional image from computer tomography, we are talking about actually mathematical model simulation. No more. It should be realistic. It must be realistic in case of made decision on it. But we must be aware that we are talking about synthetic object mathematical model only. So difference in quality between different generation of tomography. Modern tomography actually no need moving part. We have like two rings, target and sensor ring. So here is how we can get half arc image, for example, how other done it by reconstruction. What I'm talking about all this time with that algorithms which implement particular mathematics. With modern tomograph, we can get only, not only static slices, but we can get multiply continuous three-dimensional model. So with this time, we use a spiral tomography and reconstruction. So technically, depending to mechanical principles of how tomograph operates, we can talk about slice by slice scanning or volumetric scanning. But again, key role play software solution which run onto CT scan computer DCU unit and which responsible to reconstruct three-dimensional image and display it to two-dimensional plane. So maybe that image. So how many times we have like simulation at this point? When we talk about reconstruction just slice, then we will turn create mathematical model which represent volumetric object, three-dimensional object. Then again we try to project this three-dimensional object to flat screen, to display on flat screen like this one. So multiply time projection do we have. Or we can simulate with image like this one. Again, there we have ability to create three-dimensional model and even use a different slicing techniques or filtering or segmentation task to identify, to assign and visualize only particular elements of image. Again, origin at left side, everything that we do we have. Even at left side, we have results of like backward Fourier transformation, even at left side. So at right side, we have same results applied like dozens of times to get three-dimensional image, to perform segmentation tasks, to cut through different components and represent internal structures. Okay, as I noted before, MRI system or which useful for soft tissue and even for study metabolism and so on, and nuclear medicine imaging SPECT PET system and so on, even ultrasound, all this represent different physical approach, a different acquisition system, but software solution almost the same, and principles of reconstruction, three-dimensional, the same, images exactly the same as in case of computer tomography. Okay. Actually, all the things what I were talking before, it's just cover first the square acquisition. So it's very simple in case if we, for example, try to take conventional photo. It's relatively simple in case if you try to get conventional X-ray digital image. But even if you want to get flat CT tomography image, I'm talking about like a lot of processing required, but they are alcohol acquisition. Okay, if you want to simulate a three-dimensional model from computer system, so we move into processing. Like sequence of computer of CT scan image, it's acquisition, but visualization of three-dimensional structure, it's a result of processing. And here is where we have involved pre-processing, segmentation, detection, analysis, and if possible, diagnostic, means automatic diagnostics, of course. So, okay, under formation, within another structure, more tailored approach. Formation of image, let's consider it's a step of acquisition and digitizing. All together, we can also entitle as formation. Then basic enhancement typically provided even in most of time inside acquisition device, but also sometimes could be provided further adjusted within DCU unit, within computer unit, like about some calibration, registration, optimization, information filtering. So our goal improve quality of image, like some brightness, contrast, denoising, another task we can implement within enhancement. So basic level, every time done inside DCU unit, but if physician required made adjustment, brightness, contrast to the illumination of room, so this time we talk again about calibration, but now within end user device and DCU unit. And after that we have three approach. So when we, after we complete enhancement, actually we have ready to useful medical image, medical digital image. And we can do with this image three things. Display it to physician, make decision by himself, what happens with this patient, what should do next. Here is given techniques and information technologies approaches, which so like surface compression, illumination, shading, which is required to create, especially if we talk about three-dimensional image and display it on flat screen. Actually, steps similar to computer games, and it's true, because it's absolutely the same information technology, absolutely the same visualization techniques being used in computer games industry, for example. No matter what, no difference here. Okay, then. Right side, management, like we want to get, we want to store our data and reuse it. We want to, for example, take photo now, take X-ray imaging CT scan now, after treatment in several months, compare, make assessment about result or so, question related to management. And it's critical things. And I look every time, as what students have get this impression about this, I'm every time very angry about data management question. I am sorry, and I sign these things. There is no any reason to use a computer system if you do not have ability store and after some time retrieve the data to compare with Nevis. Sorry. If you doesn't have ability to manage computerized data, no matter if we talk about text or visual, sorry, would be better to use a paper copy, film copy or so. And it's reason why I am very strong and even angry with that question. If you can save an open data file, means you did not do nothing. Zero result. Sorry. Okay, and at the middle of we have analysis, and actually I want to add that means automated analysis, automated processing of that image, like extract fiction, segmentation, classification, measurements in interaction would be fine, if computer system algorithms provide automatic analysis or guided by physician. And here is practical classes about usage image, maybe swap. It's kind of analysis guided by students. So here is also, we are in this structures. Ability to save data processed by image, it's management within this picture. So we are all together within this structure. Okay, again, one more time, back to matrix. If we talk about do something with image, it's actually, again, matrix transformation. You want to, like, enlarge or decrease size, change, like, colors, rotate 90 degrees, for example, or so, made X, Y shifting, so it could be represented by particular matrix multiplicator. So we need to like multiply our matrix of image by that particular matrix and we will get our result. And for example, if you talk about pre-processing, I talk about filtering, the noise integration, transmit, so operation which is required. Each one represented by separate algorithm. I will now, at this point, I will not dive inside this algorithm. If you are interested, you can check internet resources and you can get mathematic of different solutions for these algorithms. Typically, physician will work with graphical user interface, which allow to make this adjustment in the interactive model. But it's required to understand about existences of this and about difference between what is actually a kind of system. So for example, reconstruction of gray level, when we turn full scale gray level 256 value into bin binary, the two-color image. So how we lost details here? You will have such task with image J. Okay, for pre-processing, filtering, median, mean, wavelets, and actually not all because we have much more methods. So general idea of fixed pixel, we construct matrix element by information obtained gathered from their neighbors. But this particular algorithm, and here is given algorithm like for mean filter, Laplacian, nonlinear filtration, so on. Attention, please don't mix, it's not scaling of image. For each one of that four red neighbors will be updated same algorithms as for it right now in the center. Every time we will repeat it for each one pixel. And we will get how it can look like. Okay, if you talk about image, free open source solution for medical image processing. It could look like this one. Even you don't need to dive into matrix. So you just open image, apply particular filter from menu, and you will get necessary results. But you must understand which filter must be used in which condition and with which possible goal. So for this, okay, user manual for this application, book about 200 page, and in addition, would be fine if you are looking for books which will represent application of image for particular speciality, for example, for histology or so. Because such instruction also available in separate books about also several hundred pages. Behind small interface, great power. So another, not for image solution, when you talk about difference in filtering. What do we get in mammography from same image? How, which kind of transformation do we have with different methods? Again, actually behind this contrast enhancement algorithm or histogram equalization method. If you will check Google, you will see mathematical and matrix methods used in both cases. Segmentation task. Actually, with segmentation, we can delimitate objects to identify borders or distinguish point between different kinds of objects. So here is we can identify organs, tissues at particular image. Manually or with some kind of automatic approach. Or further analysis, segmentation could give for us solves for three-dimensional segmentation and visualization of three-dimensional structure. When we retrieve only part of image which related to particular criteria, and we can, for example, reconstruct only vessels from general MRI or CT scan, no, and remove our other components which not fit our filter criteria. Okay, segmentation task with maybe swap, identification of border of different tissue, border of skull or brain tissues or so. Here is like relatively simple components. Sometimes students are very hard to create this. I do not understand why actually. It's like a pre-constructor, like Lego or so, with slightly advanced box. Here is this one, segmentation task. No need again matrix processing, just need to know which model is responsible for what and which kind of operation perform. So actually multiply algorithms when you use it. If you want like perform kind of scientific investigation about segmentation algorithms, so welcome here. Так, final results could be that right part of image. Right part I sign. It's a result of segmentation. It could be for us. That cross-section slice removing not use tissue and only sign and determine, so we can't analyze like bones or vessels or so, or even made custom cut and slices. Okay, with segmentation we are looking about noun patterns and slightly different task is detection when we want to identify artifacts which should not be available within our data. For example, in case of medical images, it could help us to identify like kind of pathological components which included and displayed with this within image. So in this case, we are like excluding noun parts and looking for something unusual. So this case will be detection. Or also we can identify components of picture. So in this case, for example, we can, when we combine and looking for difference between different type of image like PET and CT scan, so when we use an image, we can identify very easily identify possible pathological object. Or another solution when we combine different type of image, but we should have this image must have in digital format and must be able like bring them into relatively same characteristics like resolution or color depth or so, and also usage into diabetic diagnostics, possible usage when we retrieve normal and retinopathy data. Okay, before I will move into a third question of lecturer, kind of final notice about understanding of past, present and future of medical images. So despite it's slightly outdated picture, but it's reflect situation with high developed country when they consider the question related to image acquisition and pixel manipulation and data management already resolved. So we have our diagnostic, we are equipped with imaging systems and we have like computer system for storage and exchange medical data. We now need no longer worried about this. We should concentrate on like analysis question, formation functional images from multiply maybe, or dynamical images, registration multimodal images. So combine that different sources, CT plus MRI, add fMRI, create as a result dynamical representation and so on. And also analysis like measurement, segmentation, detection, and others. It should be like current practical application, not scientific or prototypical. And if you talk about scientific achievements, so it should be future working on, like computer-aided diagnostics, treatment planning, creating multidimensional dynamic, multimodal images from all possible sources, and even up to computer-aided surgery and so on. Sounds slightly fantastic, but okay, even Da Vinci robotic surgery system, it's like maybe not full implementation of CIS technology, but it's closer to it. It's closely to it. So, about third question in brief. PACS and DCOM, picture, hearing communication system and digital image communication method. Okay, we got a series of advanced images of patient, whole body, organs or so. What we should do next? Next question, it will be management of it with help of system, information system like this one. A little bit more about this system, I will talk in next semester about dedicated lecture, but right now only quick introduction. Special kind of information system called picture human communication system. So it could be started from single computer or typically network or even cloud solution, which dedicated storage, retrieval, distribution and presentation of image. So it's about to share medical image between professionals, between hospital departments, between even different hospitals. Major characteristics of this system, it's support of DCOM, supports of data stored in DCOM format or transmitted in DCOM format. Digital medical communication medicine, international standard dedicated to exchange of medical images, to store and exchange of medical images, actually. So actually main goal of PACS is to replace hard copy of medical images in form of film or paper and create single access point where our physician from even different hospital will be able to access medical image, visualize it and also perform different analysis. So attention, it's not only storage, it's also include the analytical tool which allow to perform different measurements, like Tamkron, create cross-section, slices, and other kind of analysis, perform of visual data. And here is difference between, for example, PACS and like EMR system, or even online cloud storage like Google Drive or so. It's ability to perform analysis. And of course, access control level and other related things. So, next important point is ability to exchange data and even integration with other kind of medical information system, sorry, like radiology information system or hospital information system. Так, as of about architecture, it could be quite a bit different. So here, given what about solution, like central server based within LAN, local area network, global area network with application of different technologies, web-based solution. Actually, at modern time, we are to move to our cloud solution, and very often such system available by subscription for hospital or individual physician. So provider support, keep and maintain all network cloud system, and just offer for physician access to this system by subscription basis, like monthly, yearly or so. Client software could be again a local solution or even web-based too. So actually in modern time, technology have less matter than before. Possible structures and actual integration shown here, like we talk about integration multiply DCOM images from data packages, from diagnostic acquisition device in common, and provide access for physician, as well sometimes as patient, by their workstation and even create hard copy backup. No problem. It's not a bad idea to have like storage in case of disks, films, papers, but it's like second level of backup. First level, it's cloud system itself. Second level, it's backup of cloud system for sure, like in even different data center, in would be better if in other country to improve reliability. And then also we can create hard copy, no, for sure. It's not a bad idea to have it. And how it could look like? Here is we have about dozens solutions, maybe hundreds right now. It could be variety from that things at the left side, like clear PACS system to PACS model inside the medical information system at the right side. And if you will brief intro into DCOM, so what is DCOM? Again, international standards for handling, storing, printing, and transmitting information in medical, in form of medical images. So it's contained of two parts: data file format and network communication protocol. It's important to remember that DCOM is not data file. It's also network communication protocol, which based and on above TCP/IP level. So we can have imaging device which will transmit data into the network directly as DCOM stream. But we must have listener in that network which will be available intercept, accept, and store that stream and turn into something useful, at least on screen information. So actually we are and now use it to transmit data in form of files or stream between different facilities, between different offices, between departments in hospital or physician workstation, no matter actually. Scale there, no matter in this case. It could be within one room or even with across continents, no matter. Responsible organization, National Electric Infrastructure Association of the United States, for sure, holds copyright and responsible for support and maintain, but again adopted as international standard in frame of HL7 standard groups. So here, okay, what is most important in case of DCOM data format is that it consists of multiplied data sets. It's not only contain imaging data itself, but it also supply altogether with image data essential information about patient, clinical case that this image obtained within this clinical case. Information may be clinic, physician, acquisition device, and so on. For sure, even JPEG contain EXIF metadata, but here is we are talking about data set in form which is compatible with HL7 standard, like so DCOM data set contain multiplied data set which are HL7 compatible about patient, physician, like clinical case or so. What these things, it's important to understand it. And one of these data set, so we have DCOM container, which contain multiply HL7 data set with patient, physician, and other data. And one of these container included, largest container for sure, included visual information, included digitized picture for sure. So here is, if you decode the DCOM data, you have full information about what is kind of image, where, when, from whom, by whom, with which settings obtained, and what is being used for which purpose. In one case, for sure, if person who is responsible for perform image acquisition fill all necessary fields. Sometimes it's not due. Okay, even if we have imaging equipment like outdated, but still in working condition, which does not support DICOM itself, no problem. We need only have computer attached to it. We need only have a way to digitize image data. And if so, there is a lot of different software solutions which allow to convert it into digital DICOM format. Even maybe Swab, it's one of these, or even ImageJ. We can open particular T4 JPEG, provide extra details, and save in DICOM format. And then transmit into other workstation within PAX network. Okay, example of such utils, one or two. Every time, and even free and open source, by the way. So here is given link. If you want, you can review, check it. Use a visualization of DICOM images, or even creating of it. So that's everything that I want to show for you. Thank you for your attention today.